Welcome to Embedded World 2025. We are at the booth of MikroE with the one and only Mr. Matic, the CEO of the company.
Good to see you again.
Sir, I've heard that MikroE is developing boards, one board per day.
Yeah, we have one new product per day. Every day, if you have time, go 10 o'clock in the morning, you will see a new product. So yesterday was, I think, a new version of the Necto Studio. Today, I don't know,
yeah, it's 9:50,
because it's not yet 10 o'clock. Do you know that not a single one manager in the company are involved in process of making one new product per day? Not a single one. I don't know what's going on in 10 o'clock, in the what new product mm-hmm. will come today,
yes.
Because also any other manager, that we don't know that. So it's a beautifully designed process.
Wow. So if we will go to the how we came, how MikroE became like this, that we you are able to develop one board per day. What were the core values when you were developing at the beginning?
The core, well, the core values of the whole MikroE, mm-hmm. we are dedicated to time saving and standardization. And if you put those two things together as the imperative of your organization, then whatever you do, you are doing by time saving and standardization. So if you see click boards, our development boards, micromedias, whatever you see on our webpage, there is a standard following this. And whatever we do have to save some time, because we believe we are in a business of selling time to yourself. So we are selling your time to you. So with our tools, you could do the most with the time you have. So that's the key message from MikroE to any of our customers.
Yeah, so but not only in hardware, but also in software. And how do you... Is it true that MikroE started as a magazine?
Yes.
Yeah. How did you manage to go...
It's actually simple. The magazine is the biggest business. You could start with the smallest amount of money. So that's the we start as a magazine. Then our reader says, okay, where to learn those microcontrollers? Then we start to publish the books. Once when we publish the books, they say, okay, where to try what we read and learn? Then we start to make dev tools. Uh-huh. And then one day I was trying to make some LED blinking example in some compilers, and after half an hour, without success, of course, I see we need to make compilers.
Okay.
So we start to make compilers. And now we create completely new concept, like a Planet Debug, so board farm, like embedded wiki, project platform, you know, the Necto Studio, multi-language, multi-compiler, multi-architecture, multi-vendor environment, you know. So many innovations.
Was there any specific innovation or solution that you've seen that people started working with MikroE and developed that inspired you? That
let's say like this. There is I'm really proud what we do and how, you know, if we calculate how much time we save to all engineers in the world, it's a billions of hours. But I'm very proud on one concept. We call it Planet Debug.
Okay.
So we are born in countries where we have many resources to become what we want to become. Mm-hmm. So just imagine if you are born in the country where is no DHL, no UPS, no dev tools options, no good schools. So with the Planet Debug, you are able to connect and to work on a very expensive board with a really good software. You could change your destiny if you are born in some country which is not well organized and technically kind of up to some state. So I'm proud to this because it's very rare that one company could impact on so many people in the world with so small resources. So, you know, that's make me proud.
What was different in MikroE that engaged with the community? There was I understand that there were some questions, where can we do this, where we can learn that, but how did you start this, the whole community and the support?
Well, it's You start with a web page, then you have a forum, then you reply on forum on time, you know, you build a community build, and then some customer buys something, recommend to another. So, you know, you are creating that buzz around you.
Yes, I think if it's a good product, it's going to be recommended to others and word to word, mouth to word.
Yes, yes, but a little bit marketing and a little bit sales doesn't harm. So, you know, and you are exactly doing right right now. So you are in the marketing. But it's a question. So you are distributing components, yes, and everything. So we are creating tools. We are not here to sell that we sell you something or you are selling us something. We are here for our customers.
Right.
So how our customer be more successful in our corporation? Mm-hmm. So if we think like that, that's exactly what we need to do in the future, and we are already doing this. So we have to think about the customer. Customer is the key. So if they buy the tools and they are happy, they will start to buy components to finish the, you know, second level of the prototyping or the third one, I don't know. Mm-hmm. Then, you know, if you deliver on time, we deliver on time, we help them. So our customers is more successful. There is a product coming out. So, you know, that's what we need to do.
I'm sorry, when you are making one board every day, how, and are there some boards that, you know, constantly, let's say, on demand, and some of them are less in demand? How do you...
How we choose what to do?
Yeah, in this product.
It's very simple. If you are customer-oriented company, so if, for example, is there... If you have 100 customers, mm-hmm, only for one product, mm-hmm, would you make it or not?
Yes.
In my case, we will make it, because those 100 customers are also important.
Yes.
And you will be surprised. Okay. Some clicks I was convinced they will not sell. Uh-huh. There is a click, I always remember that click, with the four buttons.
Okay.
So do you really think we need a click with the four buttons? And I ask some of the engineers, you know, who is that smart guy who make this? And do you know how many of those clicks we sell in, I don't know, last 5-10 years? I don't know when we introduced this click. About a couple of thousand.
Wow.
So for something I was really convinced, no way we will sell more than 10. Mm-hmm. So you see, there is always a customer who wants exactly that product for who knows what.
All right. Can I ask about the standardization that
yes,
you already...
Please.
How... also, you become from education and telling people how and introducing those clipboards. How do you make those standardizations? How do you... I mean, I guess you submit some forms, right? But how you decide that, okay, this is going to be the standard?
You see how click look like. It's very simple. There is a 8 pins here, 8 pins here, and there is a 3 dimension. But you see the wide. The how click is wide, I have to open about 1,000 PDF from everything, or even more. For everything we like to see on the click, just to decide the size. So you see, only, and then you see all the modules are perfectly fit there, etc. Uh-huh. So, and that's exactly what we do with the SDK. Exactly what we are doing, whatever we do a lot of preparation to check everything. So when we are creating SDK, we didn't create SDK for just one type of the microcontroller or one vendor.
Right.
So we create SDK loading in every single microcontroller family to see how it's performed, and then decide this is the standard. It's a painful job. And to be honest, I prefer that someone else do the standardization and then we follow.
But you decided that this needed right now.
Let's say, like, when you say we decided, we didn't decide it. No one else took the job. So that's we. Then we say, okay, someone have to do it.
Right.
So that's.
So, but you are also leading and updating it constantly?
Right. So you Necto Studio is the first IDE with a daily update. Mm-hmm. Did you know how many microcontrollers we add daily in Necto Studio?
5? 10.
How about good. You are good.
No.
Okay, but 10. That means in a couple of years, every single microcontroller in the world will be in Necto Studio under one code base. Oh. So whatever you wrote, it will work on all of them.
Wow.
Of course, if you have the memory or, you know, we can't extend the memory. We are not that in that God mode. Maybe.
Would you like to, can we go right now and see some of the products?
Yes, please.
All right.
Follow me. I'd like to show you the Planet Debug, how it looks like. Basically, it's a camera pointing to hardware setup, but the real magic is on this side. And that's the guy who allows everything. This is a CodeGrip programmer, the first debugger over the Wi-Fi in the world. Whoa. So it takes us about 3 to 4 years to make it. And you know, don't forget we are talking about the company who makes one product per day. So pretty fast company, and just imagine how hard it is. So you see, everything from that side is connected to the Wi-Fi, and then if you combine it with the live streaming, you get the magic. And then you see in real time what board is doing till you are debugging, programming, etc.
From everywhere in the world.
Can you touch the board?
Sorry.
If you are, for example, can you touch the board which is in Mexico?
No.
Well, are you sure?
I don't know.
Yes,
I guess
you could.
I could.
Because the microcontroller, what microcontrollers want see and want to see is the signal. Is the signal came from your finger, or it is done on another way that's for, from his point of view, it doesn't have a, you know, meaning too much.
Wow.
So that's how it looked like. And just imagine in Belgrade we have a 150 those setups. So in the future you will see board farms with the thousands of the boards where any person in the world could access. It's a kind of a rent-a-car. You know, you rent the board, and if you, of course, if you need it for a long time, and you know, then you will buy the board.
Right.
Similar with the car. You need it for 5 days, you will do rent-a-car. If you need it for every day, go to work, of course, you will buy the car. So that's how it looked like. And you see here, we just show you the power of standardization. So you could create this tower and try, for example, projects with, 20 click boards, 50 click boards. So you could make extremely complex projects. We just introduced in Necto Studio AI model in which you could combine 2, 3 or more clicks into one code.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's not that we give you about, 1,800 of the click boards, but we now give you possibility of billions and billions of combination. So again, don't forget, everything is about of time saving.
Right.
So if we are not saving time, you know, if you need money, you could always go to the bank. But if you need time, where you are going? Yes, exactly, nowhere. So you could create things. So if you see how quadcopter is created, you could create, you know, whatever you want. So that's quadcopter, for example, and that's how you control it. You know, it's always in some plastic, you don't know what is it. It's actually two joystick, RF communication and display.
Yes.
So many nice things. This one is as we speak, connected to the public radio and give you the temperature in many towns. So, you know, it's so easy to create extremely complex application. So you see here on this board, you have a 5 sockets. Five socket with this number of the click boards. Do you know how many unique combinations you could create on one board? It's a big number. It's a
every one slot is one.
Yeah, it's 1, unique combination. So you have a 1,800.
1,800 per each slot.
And 5 slots. Wow. So a unique combination. It's about 120. Uh, I don't know, is it billions or trillions? Trillions, yes, trillions. Sorry. So trillions. So if you spend 1 second for each, you need about,
wow,
it's about a little bit less than 4 million years to try what we have today. So you see, this is so important for us that we could really save time to any person in the world.
Uh-huh.
So if you are doing whatever you are doing, you know, we are covering 235 areas of embedded.
I have a question.
Please.
So let's say this is the simple board, right, that we have, the four button board, let's say.
Don't mention this. This okay. still bothers me.
Just a board that you already are offering. Sometimes, I know that it's going to save me time, but I have to do it my own way. I want to try. I want to.
You're speaking from the hobbyist point of view, but okay. if you're in the company, your management
right.
should not allow you to lose time. You know, we know. You know, I'm an engineer. Do you really think I don't want to play, etc.? You know. So yes. the question is, what you are doing as a hobbyist? Mm. That's your thing. You could do it right. at your home for a weekend, etc. But in the company, you have to be productive.
Right.
You have to. And it's not about just losing time by, you know, developing something which we have for $20.
Mm-hmm.
In our case, you could try many other paths and then choose the best one. If you are making everything by yourself, you don't have time to try. So my question to you, do you know how many Wi-Fi modules you have in the world?
No.
Dozens and dozens, or hundreds, hundreds.
Oh, okay.
You will be surprised.
Oh my God.
How some are performing bad compared to others.
Mm-hmm.
And if you pick the wrong one, you will have issues in your project, etc. So if you choose the right one, mm-hmm. then your project will be, you know, working pretty good, etc. Trust me. If you want to have a Wi-Fi module with a holds connection to the board in Mexico
mm-hmm.
On a bad Wi-Fi mess, well, you need to have a really good one.
Thank you very much for the interview.
My pleasure.
It's you brightened my mind, my brain, and yes, I know some of the management won't be satisfied with my projects, but I will try MikroE from now on. Thank you, Matić.
Good decision.
Thank you.